So can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. There was some problems in restarting my machine. There was no problem with the machine, but problem was with the Microsoft Teams. Anyway, I will start with the lecture. In fact, today's lecture is a simple and straightforward lecture. What I am going to cover today is related to operating system versions as well as the comparison of operating system. That is the topic mentioned in chapter number 2. Let's go for so now you see some of the pictures here. These are the trademark symbols of different operating systems. So very first is your Apple computer system, that is Macintosh. Then second is Linux operating system. Third, you will be familiar with this Windows operating system, Lego. This iOS operating system, which is used for Apple mobiles. And then this next one is your, again, familiar with the mobile Android operating systems. And another is Ubuntu operating systems. So exactly what is operating system? So if you see operating system, it lies between the application and hardware of a machine. In fact, it helps you whenever you see any, if you see the layer architecture or how actually your computer works. So hardware, it is actually your physical hardware. Operating system actually is the interface between the hardware and user. But here, when you say user, user actually runs the application. And to run the application, operating system helps how to run this particular application and how to deal with that particular application. Maybe how to allocate the processor, how to find out that particular file, how to allocate a memory, how memory is to be managed, how processor instructions are to be executed. These are done with the help of operating system and the hardware. If there is any problems, then of a hardware, actually this operating system communicates to the user after interacting with either application or hardware. So you can say, in simple definition, as we say, operating system is the interface between the user and computer. So from this picture, it should be clear to you. Now if you see the role of operating systems, or what are the functions of operating systems, the very first is the process management. So every application is divided into different processes. If you see a task manager or control alt delete, then you come to know that every application is divided into different processes, and that is managed by operating system. Then every application needs to give certain memory of allocation, and memory that has to be, when it is to be loaded, where it should be loaded. If it is terminated, then how this memory should be removed from the, how this application should be removed from the memory. Or memory management, all these are the deep memory management is one of the functions. Similarly, file management, how to locate a file, what is a file system, what, which file is there, then how, what file ID. If you just click on the file, then entire process runs behind, and actually it helps operating system. So file management actually called the device management. This device management means how your floppy disk or a pen drive or even a hard disk works, or how this is actually interpreted, how this data is taken from your operating system into buffer, into memory, and say maybe reading writing operations. All this is done under device management. Then nowadays we require to have a security management, so that any devices or even users, whatever they are authenticated, as per their authentication and role, the thing should go run. For then if there are multi-processing other tasks to be done, then which job should be processed first, and then how it should be queued, how it should be executed. Then secondary storage management, as we said here, this is a maybe optical disk management or tape management or your pen drive management. These are all comes under secondary storage. So process management is actually repeated here. Then networking, how network should be connected, and then related, any works related to the networks, and coordination between other softwares and users. So these are the basic functions of operating system. So here, now The most popular operating system, which all we use, most of the in India, almost we use 80 to 90% Windows operating system users are there. Hardly 10-15%, they are at a higher end, or maybe some for specific applications they are running for maybe Linux, Unix, or very few users, maybe less than 1%, will be working on Macintosh or Apple operating systems. So let's see. Now, what are the various versions of operating system? If you see from this diagram, you'll find Windows started somewhere in 1985. And now in 2015, this Windows 10 version, that is the latest version into the market. There are lots of improvement in this particular Windows software. As you are aware, now I need not explain you what is the version of any software. So you are all aware, because you are using a mobile and you know what is the latest Android version of your mobile operating system. So version is nothing but this is an improvement in the earlier software. So here, whenever there is any improvement, maybe for giving additional user facility, some improvements over the, maybe that is related to application improvement, some hardware supports, or maybe some of the things get executed faster. So whatever the changes, and the users' demand are normally satisfied in the newest or released version, or this is definitely an improved version than the earlier one. So let's start with this. After this, covering this, these are all the versions related. I mean, say these are the disk desktop operating systems. Now, if you see Windows, similarly serves for server operating system. So here in Windows server operating system, if you say Windows server actually started with Windows NT, that is 4.3.1 and 4.0. Later on, Windows NT is developed into Windows 2000 server. Then after this, Windows 2000 dedicated server came into the market, that is Windows 2005 server. Then after 2005, 2008, there is the 2012, 2016, and 2019. So these are the different server versions of the Windows. You know already, when I say server version, that means you will have a servant client operating system, where a dedicated machine with a very high memory, good computing power, acts as a server machine. And then the different machines can be connected directly to it through the wired or wireless connection, or maybe with the switches, and anything in the world, any machines in the world nowadays can be connected with the Windows server. So even if you have a one machine at USA, and if you want to access that particular machine, maybe from Aurangabad, as you know, through net and by setting appropriately, that it is possible to access that particular machine sitting over here. So that is the advantage of what we call as a server operating system. Obviously, it has got some different features compared with the desktop operating system. So these are the different versions Windows came up with server operating system. Now let's see one by one how these operating systems evolved, or what are the versions. So as I said, when computer developed in 1980-81, IBM developed its own operating system, that is called the disk operating system. And then Microsoft immediately came up with the MS-DOS, that is the first version. And that version actually helped you in starting the computers. In fact, almost from 1987 to 88 onwards to still 1995, there are different DOS versions came into the market. These are can be named from 1.0 to 7.0. So 7.0 normally termed as a Windows first version, but MS-DOS 5 was the most good and stable version. If you see, this is the familiar prompt. If you get this particular C drive / greater than symbol, that is the C drive, the root symbol, which indicates that you are working with the DOS operating system. But somewhere in 1985, 1992, almost simultaneously, Microsoft also was working with the Windows. But they have introduced 1.0 in 1985. But it was not popular. It was just some graphic interface with computing boxes. And hence, they have given the name in something like Windows. Why they say this is window? Because instead of typing the command, remembering the commands, it was possible to give certain interface to the user by which pointing and clicking operations, certain commands can be executed without on remembering those commands on the part of user. So that was the idea behind this. And in Windows 2.0 release, when 286 processor was developed, though it was says 1987, but 286 processor came into the India somewhere in 92-93, after 5 years of its development. Then somewhere in 1994, 3.0 and 3.1, these are the improved versions, came with advanced graphics, good look and feel. Some of the features like program manager, file manager, print manager, and the well good, and the, some of the games probably you might have played with this, Hearts, Minesweeper, Solitaire. These are the, some of the games were introduced in Windows 3.0 to 3.1. Real development in Windows took place in summer 95, hence the name given as Windows 95. This was the upgraded version of this, and it is used for 32-bit application. Most important feature here is that they have removed all the DOS platform. Earlier DOS were started on the platform of a DOS. Once DOS starts, then graphics interface was given. But there they have removed all the DOS limitation, especially as we know, DOS has to be loaded into 640 kilobytes of main memory. Or if you are using config.sys higher memory, then it is possible to in upload of upper memory areas. At the same time, in C programming, you have experienced this limitation of 8 character file names of a DOS. Then that is removed in Windows 98. You can give a longer name and you can give much better name for any files, and that is taken care. Then most important feature, that is plug and play feature, is introduced in Windows 95. Then come Windows 92. 92 has got some improved facilities, such as FAT32 was introduced into it. Then advanced graphic support was there. Then MMX, that is multimedia extension technology, USB support, more earlier CD-ROMs were there. Now it is came with the DVD. Then this advanced configuration power interface was also there with the Windows 95. Then more importantly here, the Internet Explorer was introduced into the Windows June 1998. That means this first browser, that is Internet Explorer, was introduced in Windows 98. And because after introduction of Internet Explorer, and when you start working on an internet, there is no difference between accessing a file on your own hard disk or whether you are accessing a file which on the server, which may be in US or Singapore or anywhere in the world. So the from the perspective of user, it means the same whether you access the file from your own hard disk or from anywhere in the world. So that facility was possible because of the browser and related application that uses the respective browsers. So browser firstly introduced by this Microsoft in as an Internet Explorer. Then there comes some Windows Millennium Edition. This Millennium Edition Windows NT was introduced almost same at the same time in the market. The Millennium has removed boot in DOS option. That means there is no DOS support on this Windows 2000 option. But when you talk about Windows NT 3.1 and 4.0, it was really a good operating system. Basically, NT was a server operating system. That means with NT, it was possible to connect multiple number, even 400, 500 machines can be connected to the Windows server. There was no limitation as such on the number of client machine that can be called. But here, Windows NT came in two flavors, as this is 32-bit technology. Windows have given the name NT because it is a NT stands for new technology, and it was supporting multitasking. Two versions of Windows were server as well as workstation. So whenever you say client machine, that client machines or a desktop machine is actually what we call as a workstation, where actually users work and then directly you can communicate with the Windows NT. In advantage of some this type of operating system is that even if you have a Windows NT operating system, and if you have a just mouse, keyboard, and maybe a screen, that can serve your purpose, because you don't need to have any specific hard disk or a RAM or that exists into your machine. But if you have a local hard disk and a RAM, then obviously you can do the local work as well as you can do the data. What I mean, typing data and all this. So if you see the systems like railway reservation system, where they have got some workstation terminals, which are the dumb terminals, where there are no actually processor, no actually RAM. They are directly communicating with the central server. So of course, this is the cost criteria. Based on this, you can have any type of, even this Windows NT serve or supports this type of operating system, such type of works. Then comes Windows 2000. Obviously, like Windows 95, it was developed in 95. When it is developed 2000, the name is given as Windows 2000. It is also abbreviated as W2K, Windows 2000. That is hence name give us Windows 2K. It was really a good operating system in that context about in 2000, because it was used for desktop as well as laptop systems. It can connect with the internet as well as intranet sites. And there are four flavors of this particular operating system. These are called as a Windows 2000 professional operating system used for desktop or laptop systems. Then server, both for web server as well as office server. Then it is advanced server for business application, and even Windows 2000 server was used in data centers, that is for high traffic computing networks, where this actually works as a server. And even some of the, even today we are in 2020, but some of the servers may be operating with the operating system like Windows 2000 server still. Then it can be the most popular system of a Windows, probably the best stable version of operating system, that is Windows XP in 2001. It is also come up with home and professional editions. It has support of plug and play as well as wireless network. In fact, 802.11, that is wireless security standards, were introduced here. And from this XP onwards, it was possible to have a communication with the desktop machines without using wire, or that is wireless communication started. Then it's also the, as I said, to the best selling products the Windows have ever produced. In fact, it was a very stable operating system. Even I have a machine that I have purchased somewhere in 2003, but still I am using Windows XP onto that particular machine, because this is really a good operating system. Of course, good, I mean, if I wanted to go for Windows 7 or 8, I'll have to upgrade my hardware. Without upgrading the hardware, if I wanted to still run all my application at work or office or any development softwares like Visual C or even SQL Server or similar based applications, still can be run in Windows. After Windows XP, as we said in last during lectures also, this is a Windows 7 came into the market. Probably this is again a very good stable server, stable operating system. Before that, Windows Vista was tried, but it has got, of course, Windows Vista was came into the market with very good intention of giving at best security for the users. But due to certain poor design, it actually failed and it is not continued in the market. Very few people have used Windows Vista, and those are as it was having some original system bugs and those, but those are removed and Windows 7 come up with a much better version and much better facilities than Windows Vista. It is very stable, and it was actually come with Windows Server 2008 almost at the same time. It was having a multi touch supports, that means you can have a touch screen supports and all this. It was coming with the Internet Explorer 8 was introduced to this particular system. Improved performance and startup time. This is the one of the advantage of this. And it also supports virtual hard disk. And it has got another facility as it has introduced Windows Media Center, where you can manage all the audio, video, multimedia applications that can be managed with these media centers. And it also improved with a lot of security. Now this is the Windows 8 on which my laptop, actually I am using Windows 8.1. This is a very relatively version. And what is the advantage of this particular system is that if you properly manage your operating system, I mean, we shut down your system, then next time when you start up the system, it starts in a matter of seconds, because something inbuilt it is here in the operating system that whatever the good configuration it is stored, drivers are stored into certain age, and when computer starts, it automatically loads those particular good condition, good softwares, and immediately start these machines. It supports x86 as well as ARM processors. And finally, this is the latest operating system, that Windows 10. Probably some of you are using this Windows 10 operating system. It is a successor of Windows 8. And Microsoft claimed that this is the first startup and resume building system. In fact, it comes with the startup menu and expanded form. And now, nowadays, for our Windows 10 onwards, Windows is not supplying Internet Explorer, but now they have come up with another browser, the better browser, that is Microsoft Edge browser is introduced in the Windows 10. And good feature of Windows 10 is that whether you have a licensed version or don't have a licensed version, all were allowed to upgrade to the Windows 10 for a certain duration, and they are hot free of cost. Now you cannot upgrade free of cost, but it was allowed for most of the smartphones, Xbox, or even tablets, laptops were allowed to upgrade your even pirated versions with the Windows 10. That is the policy of the Microsoft Windows 10 at that time to make maybe to popularize the Windows operating system. But now you have to purchase this particular operating system. And if you see this operating system now, this is again coming in the different flavors, but if you go for home edition or maybe professional edition or enterprise edition like that, yes, the cost of this will increase from 1000 or 2000 from onwards. So normally Windows 10 software you may get about ₹5000 at the license copy. Once you have a license copy, then your most of the problems related to your desktop or laptop will be solved. But if you want to have some additional facility, you may go for professional or enterprise edition. Of course, for that you have to pay 1 or 2000 higher than the basic versions. So this is all about the versions of Windows operating systems available. Now what we'll do? Now we'll compare the actually operating systems. So to compare the operating system, it is better to you compare the most popular operating systems in the world. So probably Windows and Linux, these are the two most popular operating systems in the world. In fact, Unix was earlier popular, but due to certain Unix, as after coming this free license free software, that is a open free software, that is Linux, will come into the picture. And Linux has got a good flavor. And there are different people who have developed the Linux softwares, and in fact, Linux works relatively much better. I mean, and it has got its own market, or it has got its own, I'll say, the customers, or maybe certain organization which uses the Linux. Why it uses the Linux? Probably after comparison of Windows and Linux, you will be in a better position to say whether we should go for Linux or Windows operating system. So there are about 25-30 points on which we can compare Windows and Linux. Let's start with the comparison of this. First, who has developed it? Of course, Windows, Microsoft is a developer. And for Linux, is a Linux Torvalds community. It is not a one person, but it has a community which has developed this particular Linux operating system. Windows is written in C++ and assembly language. Similarly, Linux is assembly language as well as written in C. That is basic hardware or basic kernel is written in C and assembly language. Then it is a graphical operating system. And this Linux is very similar to like Unix-like operating system, where you need to execute the commands. And for that, a user has to know the commands, and he should be familiar with those particular commands. That means there is no as such graphical interface for this particular operating system. So obviously it takes more time to learn this particular system. A layman cannot try to start with the Unix-like system or Linux-type system. When it comes to license, of course, here you have to take a proprietary license. It is mandatory for any person using Windows they must have a proprietary license software for using it, in case then the NASSCOM for similar agencies may penalize you. But we have a tradition of say we normally use this without we most of the softwares what we use in market, these are not, we do not take a license for this. That means you don't pay for it without key, you just use what is called as a pirated software. So of course legally using pirated software is not allowed. In advanced countries they normally do not encourage this, but somewhere here we probably, this is probably the reason why Indians are more ahead than compared with the other people, because at very low cost, most of the times pirated software is available with you. You can learn it and you can make it, you can become master of it. But nowadays, you might have realized now, every software has a license, but they give certain free licenses to you where the utility or application is very at a basic level. Once you become a master, you are forced to use a license software to exploit all its advantage and facilities of this particular software. So this is, of course, this is the strategy of individual developers. Then as a Linux is a general public license, it is open to all. It's no, as such, you don't go for licensing, you can use as a free software. Default user, the interface where it is Windows shell, as you are aware, it is a explorer.exe or what you call the desktop. Through desktop, you actually interact with the Windows. Here, there is a Unix shell that is called the bash shell. Through this programming, you can, through this shell commands, you can interact with the Linux. Here, kernel type is hybrid kernel used herein. But on the contrary, here there is a monolithic kernel in Unix. Monolithic means what? The whole operating system works in the kernel space. That means there is some dedicated memory area allocated for operating system. And operating system is that this memory area reserved for operating system. And only through this you can communicate with the operating systems or command or here. So there is no such like memory management. You can load important portion at some point, and additional can be used as and when required in Windows. So the Windows is flexible as far as memory management is concerned, and that's why it has got some problems with the Windows. Source model, it is a closed source software. That means here it can be shared, and it by paying its cost, it will be shared. It is an open source software that is available with directly you can have from website, you can directly download and you can install. Nobody is going to ask about whether it is licensed or not. Its initial release is somewhere in 1985, but it is 1990. That means Windows is older than Linux. Here, this Windows operating system mostly targeted for personal computing, that is desktop users and home users. But you will find majority of the Linux operating systems are computing for a server operating system, supercomputers, cloud computing, embedded system, mainframes, mobiles, laptops, and even PCs. So this is the major area that where this Linux operating systems is being used. It is available in 138 language. Even Linux also supports multiple language, but not as much language that is supported by Windows. So these are the flat mods, that is which processor can be supported on this Windows operating system. So this is a large list of processor which can be even supported by Linux too. Official website for this Windows is Microsoft. Official website for Linux is Linux. Package manager, I mean, then how this software is distributed as a maybe as an operating system or even as an upgrade. Whenever you have to upgrade certain diverse devices, then in that case, you know, in Windows, you have a .msi files or .app application files, or even sometimes you also have a setup file that is called the .exe files. It is available in Windows. But in Linux, all the package files are all files are packaged, and that is called as a distro files. They are available in distro. So here, another important feature here, Windows file names are not case sensitive. But on the contrary, file names of Linux are kept sensitive. That means you have to be very careful while giving the names with the Linux operating system. Booting can be done only from a prime disk that we call as a bootable disk. You should have a bootable disk, bootable partitions and all this. But it is possible that it can be done. Linux can be started from almost any disk. Not necessarily it should have a bootable disk. As we say command, we give command windows are in PowerShells. That means here in Explorer desktop, you can give this, give the commands. But here bash shell is used. Windows is relatively very easy because it is rich in GUI. Comparably, Linux is normally used by technical people. For average people, it becomes very tough to learn or it takes a time consuming. And even troubleshooting process is relatively complicated in Unix. So you have to have certain average experience to be comfortable with Unix operating system. Then installation, Windows has got a very good installation. That means hardly 3-4 steps are there. If you properly caretake, then most of the time, Windows takes care of automatically, and it is easy to set up. Accordingly, Linux is not very user-friendly as far as setup is concerned. You need to have, it is rather a complicated setup. I mean install the operating system. Here, Windows is supposed to be less reliable because there are lots of loopholes. If you see the viruses and these, most of the times viruses do attack Windows because I will say there are certain loopholes still in the Windows kernel. But here we'll find Linux is highly reliable and very much secure. It has deep repo. It's very difficult to invade into this particular system. That is why we say it is very secure and reliable system. There is a lot of customization here. If you say in Windows, there are limited customization options available because every facility is given by Windows and they have come up with certain other additional facility as per the demand of the user. But Linux has many flavors and it is possible that you can customize based on the user's requirement. It is possible. Software, mostly all the Windows softwares are third-party softwares or video games. So the biggest users are there from the as far as in the world, Windows are the biggest users compared with though Linux is free. But it has got its own advantage. Easy to install software packages are there. It is free available. And nowadays you will find there are many companies like Red Hat or Linux or Kali Linux, or there are many versions of Linux are available. In fact, these companies have, like Red Hat, it has taken initiative. It do charges certain things for giving the customer supports or maybe giving certain additional customer support. So in that case, you will find still it is a low cost solution. And it has given you the good, most of the, if you really want to set up a good environment or a secured environment, then in that case, still Unix or a Linux operating systems are still used. Whenever it comes to updating the software or installing it, after installation, you require to reboot the Windows operating system. But here you do not require to update, or while updating, it takes a less time as well as a reboot is not required in case of Linux operating system. Every user does not have access to the source code. Obviously, Windows is a very restricted operating system. It is not commonly available to the user. On the contrary, code of the kernel, it is actually exposed to the users. So if any bugs, if a user is experienced one, he can fix those particular bugs faster. But at the same time, when you know something in the system, then you actually leave certain loopholes into the system. But this is taken constructively. Linux, operating system is developed for everyone. And in fact, everyone is required to use it. And at the same time, everyone is required to support it. Or maybe I will say everyone is actually cooperating to develop it and improve it. That is the policy of the Linux operating system. Here, Windows collects all the user data. On contrary, Linux never, Linux distros file do not collect user data. And finally, when it comes to cost, Windows cost is about, as I said, 5,000 to 7,000. And Linux license is relatively free. So most of the organization, you go for this particular Linux, that it may be Red Hat Linux or SUSE Linux or Ubuntu nowadays is coming into the market. Or if you want to be a big hacker, or if you want to be hacking the systems and all these, then in that case, mostly people use Kali Linux. So these are the comparisons of Windows and Linux operating system. So these are the topic introduced into your curriculum, as what is the version of operating system and what is the comparison of these two, of comparison of operating system. So hope after this particular coverage, after covering these particular things, you are in a better position to just vet which operating system is good, which is bad. Of course, it is not based on this. It is also, there are many factors which you have to take into consideration while selecting the operating system. So maybe what is your hardware, whether this hardware supports you, then what else, what likely softwares you are using, whether it is a single user or likely to be multi-user. When it is a multi-user, how you are going to execute, or what type of softwares or what type of systems that are likely to be implemented, and how is the overall environment, especially if it is a distributed and maybe on a overall LAN or a WAN environment. Especially for WAN environment, most of the times even Linux operating systems are preferred, because once those are installed, then there will be very less problems. Of course, there is a your problems are not very easily solved. You have to work on it. Of course, solutions are there, but you have to take the additional efforts in troubleshooting or solving a problem in case of Linux, as against Windows is very straightforward. So this is all about comparison of Windows and Linux operating system and the different versions that exist in a Windows operating system, right from Windows 1.0, 1985 to 2020, that is Windows 10, which is now developed in 2015. And still it is, of course, Windows 11 in the market, but it is of the, I would say it is in the beta phase, or what is we called as the inner testing phase. So this is all about. If you have got any difficulties, you please ask. So is there any difficulty?